about to begin. We'll be right back.
All right, Jim, thank you very much, and we're just beginning. Agassi in the New York court serving. Jan Siemering in the far court, and Mary Carrillo tells me that he is someone to watch.
Jan Siemering is going to be a... He could be a force in this match, which says more than you could really say about Agassi's other opponents. A young man who's already had two big wins this year over Edberg and Becker.
Oh! Agassi serving. 15 love. Here's the book on Agassi.
Agassi's ranking had dropped all the way down to number 17 in the world this spring. Of course, the win at Wimbledon helped bounce it back up to where it should be, right around 9. But he's playing better than 9. I got to figure this guy is one of the favorites to win this championship.
Yeah, I was shocked when the seedings and the rankings came out that he was not higher.
Well, Balotelli will be very happy if Jan Siemering tries to beat Andre Agassi from the baseline. That's just not going to happen.
Agassi, of course, spends a lot of time at the Balotelli Academy. One thing sure, if you stay too long there, long enough, you'll be in shape.
Barbara Streisand watching on. Andre Agassi has played so many matches in this very familiar stadium. This is only the very first game that Jan Siemering has ever played here. His coach said that perhaps it would take him a little while to settle in.
Well, he's been here once before, but never in the stadium.
Big house.
And can be intimidating. Years ago, that's a tennis player, you'd say to yourself. Everything changes. Game to Agassi. First game, first set. At the USTA's National Tennis Center, Siemering, near court, left-hander serving to Agassi. He has a good serve.
He has a very good serve and volley game, and that should be how he really tries to go against Agassi. Of course, Agassi loves facing serve and volleyers, especially pure serve and volleyers.
That was earlier today. Steffi Graf, a little trouble. Another of the Malevas, that's the one who beat Martina Navratilova.
Fifteen all.
as I was saying, Andre Agassi likes playing against serve and volleyers, and it's rare that a strict serve and volleyer can beat him.
He likes the pace, very much like Connors.
He likes playing McEnroe, he likes playing Becker, Ivanisevic, whom he beat at the Wimbledon final. And Jan Simmering is pretty much the serve and volley guy. Players who mix it up, like Jim Courier, Yvonne Lendl, they bug Agassi more.
Say goodnight. Picture book, well disguised.
And Simmering will just have to serve so well to be effective from the net. But if Agassi gets a hold of it, the man with the best return in the game can close this very talented player down quickly.
As you said, the best return in the game. 15-40. It does take it takes some, obviously, early or longer than others to get used to this stadium. Still break point.
Game Agassi.
That return just paralyzes people. Game Agassi.
Two love
in the first.
Simmering is going to have to try to serve to Agassi's forehand side. The Agassi backhand is just so good. You can see how crisp it is. Very quick tape back, great racket speed. And obviously, that's Simmering's problem. He's a lefty. So, I mean, his best serve goes into player's backhand. But that's not a great idea against the eighth seed.
The grandstand in the men's third round match, Courier leads 3-2. They're on serve. Here in the stadium, Simmering and Agassi. Agassi leads 2-love.
Don has coached Jan Simmering from the time he was 16 years old. I spoke with him before this match and said, how nervous is this guy? He's never faced Agassi. He's never played in the stadium. And he said, well, he's nervous, as you can expect. He said, but we Dutch, we have easy blood.
So easy?
Easy blood. I thought, well, that was a nice expression. He hopes that his kid will just go out and try to do what he does best, serve and volley, and hope that it'll be good enough.
Maybe living below sea level gives you easy blood.
He is such a nice guy, this guy. He's still a little overwhelmed that he's actually making a living at his playing this game. He says for years you have idols and that, then you end up playing them.
Games to one. Agassi leads first set. Stadium, Andre Agassi leading 2-1. Emmerich serving. Same age, birthdays only a couple of weeks apart. Emmerich a little taller, a little bit thinner.
Not as hairy.
Good point. Agassi's first two rounds been coasting. Today might be different.
Simmering will have more luck if he continues to serve to Agassi's forehand.
That's what he's done so far. Excuse me, Mary.
Yeah, he needed four sets to get past the first round. Again, you can't blame Simmering for trying to, normally that's a nice play. It was well directed, that serve. 90 miles an hour. This would worry most players.
But in this case, you want to stay away from that, obviously.
Must be rough, though. Agassi has already proven early on in this match how deadly his backhand return is. Now, does Simmering give up his own strength, the lefty serve to that side? He doesn't want to start compromising his strengths this early in the match. But I don't think it would be a bad idea.
Right now, let's go down to Pat O'Brien.
3-1.
All right, Pat, thank you. Kind of the singer section here. Michael Bolton behind me and Barbara Streisand here. You're here to support Andre Agassi. Why do you like Andre so much?
He's a friend of mine. And I just love the way he plays. Very kind, sensitive, spiritual. It's very emotional. I don't know. It's very beautiful to watch him play.
Beautifully said. How's your game, by the way?
Lousy.
Watching her Prince of Tennis, Barbara Streisand. Back to you guys.
And when we go back to you, Patrick, you got to sing too. Isaiah Thomas of the Detroit Pistons, his wife Lynn on his left.
Mentioning how much this man enjoys being a professional athlete, but it's taken him a while to get used to it. He said, in fact, earlier this year, he said, "I found it extremely exciting to play even the brother of John McEnroe."
Game Agassi. Game to Agassi. We'll be back at the U.S. Open after this word from your local station. Back in the stadium court, Andre Agassi. Leading 4-1, love 15 scores. Simmering serving.
Hasn't held yet. In fact, he's won more points off of Agassi's serve than his own. That's his first ace. The only game that Simmerink won is when he junked Agassi, moved the ball around, and then came in when he saw the opportunity.
Oh. 30-15.
Couple of good, strong first serves.
Again, among his wins this year, Stefan Edberg in Rotterdam. Boris Becker in Stuttgart. He says, now I know I can play the guys at the top.
Oh.
I can't think offhand of a tougher opponent for him to beat. His game matches up so beautifully against Agassi's for Agassi. Still on serve, court one. Grandstand Stadium. Grandstand Court. A couple of upsets has already happened there.
Yes.
That was
117 miles an hour.
Let for serve.
Thought I heard someone say that it hit the top of the net.
Steve Ulrich of Tampa, Florida is in the chair.
He'll serve again, first serve.
Whoa.
That's wide. Yeah, that's the place you don't want to go.
40-30.
Agassi giving the fans something to cheer about here. That was well out, he knew it.
Head.
For serve.
A little bit of sun starting to break through the clouds. You can see the shadows weren't existing in the beginning. The game to Simmerink. Flying the Fuji blimp today is a rather international flight crew. Dominic Monnier is a native of France, and Captain John McGurk hails from down under. But whatever, they've got a good seat up there, looking down at the National Tennis Center. Agassi serving. 4-2 in the first. That's good.
15-1.
Three finals in the Grand Slams lost by Andre Agassi. He said it got to the point where he wondered if he really wanted to get to another final. Of course, this year at Wimbledon, he changed it all.
30-11.
And he rounded a nasty corner by finally winning that Grand Slam title. When he lost to the at the French final in 91 to Jim Courier, his second French final loss, he said it took so much out of him. Wimbledon, he got to the quarters last year at Wimbledon. He said, you know, that was nice for a while, but he couldn't shake loose that French loss.
41.
Came here, lost in the first round here to Aaron Krikstein. Look at that, Chanda Rubin, a very, very talented American who won the junior Wimbledon title a couple of months ago. It's two games away from a great win over Katerina Maleva, the middle Maleva.
New balls.
5-2 in the first.
Agassi leads 5 games.
Agassi leads. Third round match. Crowd still milling around and filing in. And now you're back in the stadium. 5-2 Agassi, first set. Third round match. Jan Simmerink.
11-15.
Sometimes I don't think you realize what a psychological lift it is. You said a minute ago, Mary, that he finally realized he could beat the good players. You might have all the physical ability in the world, but until you start to believe it, really doesn't mean much.
It's what Patricia Hees said of herself after she defeated Jennifer Capriati on that grandstand court yesterday.
Just wonder if you can hit the ball any harder than he hits it.
I don't think so.
His demeanor has changed since he won Wimbledon. The way he walks. Stadium, the number one seed, having a battle. Courier tied at four. That's in the grandstand.
Agassi said of his Wimbledon win, "From now on, regardless of whatever else happens in my career, I'll be playing with joy instead of fear."
Wait.
Tennis Center in Flushing Meadows, New York, the stadium court. Andre Agassi in the far court. Jan Simmerink with his back to you serving.
Simmerink was broken 3 out of 4 times in the first set, but they're on serve in the second. Agassi's service return has gone off a bit. I think he's lost a little bit of his concentration because it was such a rout.
Just wide. I think Simmerich's service pattern has changed a little bit too. He stayed him an awesome return. Wisely so. Awesome from either side, maybe.
It's only an 84 mile an hour serve. That's nothing for the eyes and shoulders and racket work of Andre Agassi. That's a layup.
For sure.
Simmerich really closes after this one, and that's what helped him. All he needed to do is that. I mean, that ball looked to me like it would have been wide, but he played it anyway because he was so close to the net. He knew he could just sort of feather it over for the winner. Game point.
Well, that's a wise choice.
You might as well swipe at it. If you're a little unsure of where you're standing in the court.
Some of the other scores over in the grandstand, that's the situation. They're on serve in the second set. Costa leads Camporis. That was in the stadium earlier today. First match, Steffi Graf won. That was the upset Barry McKay just described to you. Maggie Maleva, the younger sister, the one who beat Martina, was a victor.
Navratilova is out here again today, though, playing doubles with Pam Shriver.
Jan Simmering's dad dressed for the occasion. Simmering didn't think so. But not really much of an argument. Three all, second set. I guess he won the first set. College football season underway. Alabama against Vanderbilt. Alabama ranked number 9 in the preseason polls. Clemson over Ball State 7-0. Ohio State 10-0 over Louisville. They all run together.
Agassi has been so stingy ever since he was broken in the third game of the match. He's only lost 8 points on serve.
Not stingy with his jewelry.
Serve, break a couple of times, and get himself off this court and into the fourth round without a lot of worry.
Let's take a look at Agassi's draw, and you can see what's ahead for him. Maybe Courier, maybe McEnroe.
Yeah, he shouldn't be too worried. Even though Carlos Costa is a 10th seed, he is essentially a clay court player. I can't imagine him worrying Agassi. He's leading against the Italian Omar Camporese now, 2 sets.
15-13.
really is an interesting section of the draw. Courier and McEnroe are up there. Pete Sampras is there. Ivan Isevic, who might have a tough time against Alexander Volkov. It's a very tough third round match. Awful lot of firepower up there. That's the top half of the draw. It's top heavy, I feel.
Wonder why that happens. Seems to happen more often than not.
The bottom half, I mean, it's not full of slouches, of course. Edberg's there, Lendl, Becker, Krajicek, Chang.
That's wide. 40.
Agassi's drawn an awful lot of errors off the forehand side of Simmering, both at net and from the baseline. It's got kind of a funny grip. If he's not right there behind the ball, he's in trouble.
After this word from your local station.
That's what you call a great get, and Simmering wound up with a point. These are the kind of
Agassi won the first set 6-2, the second 6-3, leads 5-3 in this one. And in this third round match, he's never really been in trouble.
Well, he started the third set. He was kind of sleepwalking, lost the first two games. And then realized that in fact he wanted to end this thing in straights. And he's had a pretty good run of late.
Waiting for the crowd to get settled. Just one of the many distractions that make this the toughest tournament there is. The airplanes, the rattle of trains.
Blimps. Simmering had gotten himself in a good position to win this point, but when he was dragged off balance, he couldn't recover it for the final smash. Still trying, though, in these last moments of the third round.
15 all. Agassi up two sets to love and leads 5-3 in this one.
Thank you.
15-40. Right now, let's go down to Tim Ryan.
Well, thank you, Pat. Straight set victory for Andre Agassi, impressively today against Jan Siemerink, who could have been a dangerous performer for him, but Agassi cruised.
About yourself?
Yeah, I don't know if I can call it breezing. I mean, obviously, I haven't had any threats as to for me to lose a match, but to come out here and beat these guys and just stay on top of them the whole way is not easy. I feel like I'm really playing well in order to do that.
You are playing well. What goes through your mind right now? Do you feel you can win this tournament? I mean, you have to feel that for your confidence level, right?
Well, to be honest, there's not a tournament that I play that I don't feel I can win. The question is when you get to those big guns, are you going to be able to hit that next gear? And you know, that's what it boils down to. You know, to beat these guys is something you got to play, 80% of your game. But to win the tournament, you got to play 100% of your game at the right times.
Down the road, you may see, I know you guys don't like to talk about down the road, but you may see Curry or McEnroe. Is McEnroe giving you any advice about this tournament? You guys have become pretty good friends.
Yeah, we're really good friends, but unfortunately I haven't had time to, he's not staying in the city these 2 weeks. I was getting on him a little bit for not staying in the city. There's so much energy there, but I haven't had a chance to talk to him. I definitely will before the week continues.
Have you had a chance to think about Carlos Costa, who you have in the next round?
I'm not sure. Has he won yet? I don't know even if he's won.
Yes, he has.
He has, okay. Well, Costa is a really, really good clay court player. I think it's to my advantage on the surface, but he's a strong player, and he's going to make me work to beat him, just like these other guys have. So if I can stay focused, I feel pretty confident.
Kind of a celebrity crowd over here watching you. Michael Bolton and Nicholas Sheridan and Barbara Streisand. You like that?
Yeah, just a few friends of mine come out and watch me play, so that's kind of nice. I go watch them do their thing every now and then, too.
Can tell this is a new generation. When you were talking to the umpire, you said, "My goodness," to him. Good luck down the road, okay, Andre?
Thanks.
Thank
Appreciate
you.
It.
Back somewhere, I guess, to Tim Ryan.
Thank you, Pat. Good a place as any as we see the fans.